We are going to carry on using synonyms. So, as a recap, can you remember what a synonym is? So, have a think about that now. And I think from yesterday's lesson on grammar, what is a synonym? So, a synonym is a word with a similar meaning to another. For example, the word small and the word tiny are synonyms of each other. So, for our first little lesson today, we're going to look at how we can change the underlined word to an up-level word in each sentence. So let's take the first sentence first of all. So we've got Ron held his wand. So we're looking at the verb held, which is from the verb to hold. So let's think of other words that we could put rather than held. So we could put the words that he grasped. We could put the words that he clutched. We could also write that he clasped. Another one we could use is the word that he actually hugged. Another word for holding something is when we hug it. Okay, so we had to think about which one of these words would make the most sense in that sentence. Now, the word hugged means that he was holding it, like he didn't let it go, like it was something precious to him. The word clasp means that maybe he grabbed it and he clasped hold of it, he got it quite tightly. Clutched and grasp are quite similar in meaning, that they clutched hold of it and he grasped it out to somebody's held his hand. So in this sentence, I'm going to use the word clutched. So my sentence would say, Ron clutched his wand, meaning that he wanted it ready in order to beat the troll. So in my next sentence, I've got the sentence, the troll in the toilet was huge. So now we're describing how big the troll was in size, and we use the word huge. So other words we could use rather than huge are vast, we could use the word great, we could use the word enormous. Could use the word immense. So if we're thinking about the troll now, a troll isn't just tall. So as I haven't put the word tall down because the word huge doesn't mean that he's just tall, it means that he's tall but also he's quite wide as well. So all these three words are actually quite similar in meaning. They all mean that the thing we're describing is not only tall but it's quite wide in itself. Now, the word vast we'd normally use to describe an area of land, it being quite a wide area, so I'm going to ignore that one and put it in the bin. The word great in this sentence, if they put in there, we could put the troll that was great, it could think we mean the word good. It's a bit ambiguous, so we're going to put that one in the bin as well. So then we've got left enormous and immense. Now, in this sentence, let's read it back and let's see which word we think makes the most sense. The troll that was huge. The troll on the toilet was enormous. The troll on the toilet was immense. So again, the word huge here describes how the size of something. Immense normally describes how bad something is in pain, like in immense pain, quite a lot of something. So I'm going to put that one in the bin as well. So I'd like you now to have a go at the last one for me. Hermione shook under the sink. Have a think about how did Hermione shake? Or why did Hermione shake? What was making her shake? So what other word could you use instead of the word shook? So pause the video, have a look at your sentence, and then press play when you are ready. So today you've got two tasks to do. You're going to watch the clip from YouTube, and it's where Harry sees the dog, and then also then the Nightbus comes along. So I want you to watch this clip first of all, up to 1 minute 42 to help you to replace the underlined words in each sentence. So you've got Harry ran down the stairs to the door. Harry walked out of the house and down the street. In the distance, Aunt Marge flew through the air, and outside was dark and cold. The iron swing swung. So each underlined word I would like you to replace with a synonym using a thesaurus to help you. When you have done that, you can watch the rest of the video clip and then write six sentences using up-level synonyms. So think about the words you are using and try and use some adventurous words. When you have done your sentences, if you can underline them so that we can see when you give your work in to us which words you chose. If you got stuck with anything today or you need any extra help, remember you can email me or Miss Williams.